Yo, what up? I'm back at you. It's me again, Mike Carter. We about to get... Yo, what up? I'm about to get into health tips, health advice, health information, however you want to look at it or whatever on this thing on video right here. I have not done a health video in a couple of weeks and I have been slacking, but today I'm back all the way on it, okay? Yes, today's topic is hyperthyroidism, and it is also known as Graves' disease, or also known as overactive thyroid. And if you don't know what the thyroid is the butterfly-shaped gland that is in your neck, and it's responsible for the metabolism that is in your body. And it's hyperthyroidism comes along whenever you have produced too much of the T4 hormone from the thyroid, and it's been released in the body, and that has caused the metabolism to be all the way off balance and stuff. Yeah, I know you've heard a couple of celebrities talk about this, mainly like Missy Elliott. People really want to know why she went from Big Missy to Little Missy. It's because she has hyperthyroidism. Her metabolism is all the way off, and we're going to get into some of the signs and symptoms and things of this whole disease, this autoimmune disease, in a few minutes. You've also heard about Wendy Williams. I can't even talk. Wendy Williams, she has recently came out that she has had Graves' disease, and that's the reason why she has the bulging eye effect or whatnot. And I actually chose to do this topic because my mother has Graves' disease, and she's had some flare-ups as well. It's definitely a controllable disease. It is definitely autoimmune. If you don't know what that is, it's where your body starts attacking its own immune system, and that's pretty much what's going on. Here, the thyroid gland is part of the endocrine system, and it is responsible for controlling the breakdown of calories, also your heart rate, and also your metabolism in the body, which is pretty much, you know, normal cell functions and how your body begins to break down different things and function normally. Okay, so boom, let's move along to some health risks. Some of your health risks are, you know, being a woman is more common in women. This also affects people that are over the age of 60 years old, and also people that are having other thyroid issues as well. And as I stated earlier, as my mom had it, it's hereditary, so you can get it from, you know, your parents or grandparents through like any kind of conditions they may have in their health history and stuff. So boom, let's move along. Dang on, some of the complications that can go along with hyperthyroidism is having thyroid nodules, which is where you have like a nodule on your thyroid and all that. Developing thyroiditis, which is inflammation of the thyroid, where the thyroid is really just inflamed and it's really all the way off balance. And also consuming too much iodine in your diet, which is coming from your salt and different kinds of fish and things. And also as well, what's the last one? Consuming time and taking too much dango Synthroid, which is the pill that is created to mimic the thyroid hormone and all that. So this is for people that have hypothyroidism, okay, which is have a decrease in the hormone and stuff. Some of the signs and symptoms that a person will want to look out for is nervousness, irritability, mood swings, fatigue, muscle weakness, heat intolerance, a goiter. If you don't know what a goiter is, it's pretty much where the thyroid has swollen up to this big softball size thing in your neck, and you have this big bulging neck effect thing going on. Also some insomnia, trouble sleeping, hand tremors, rapid heart rate, and infrequent bowel movements, or also known as diarrhea, and weight loss as well. And those are some of the things that you definitely need to be looking out for if you suspect that you have some dang on thyroid issues and all that. Let me reach over here, grab my motherfucking paper. And some of the testing things that you would hope that the doctor would test you for would be to do a T3 and a T4 test, also a thyroid hormone stimulating test, and also a thyroid scan as well. So you would want your doctor to perform these tests so that way he can get an accurate diagnosis, and always your regular CBC, your comprehensive blood panel, and your CMP and your metabolic panels and stuff like that. Okay, boom, let's move right along. Dang on, some of the therapies and treatments that you would probably go under would be to, one, get your thyroid pretty much deactivated, which is where they would make you take a radioactive iodine pill, and you would be taking that for the rest of your life, which is pretty much what happened to Missy Elliott, which is the reason why she has to take that. She got it deactivated, and so therefore it's just sitting in her neck, but it has no function, and the pills do everything that a thyroid gland would do normally. And also you can get a thyroidectomy, which is the complete removal of the thyroid, which means you wouldn't have any of that hormone in your body. Boom. Some of the foods and herbs and stuff that you all can eat to help control this whole disease right here. Let's start off with a few. Number one is turmeric. It is an actual herb. Bulgi weed is another herb. Lemon balm, garlic as well. Kefir, also avocado, mackerel, carrots, cabbage, mother's wort, omega-3, and broccoli. And the reason why these herbs and foods are good for you, because they have anti-inflammatory properties about them. They also have thyroid hormone blocking properties in them as well. So these are the foods that you would eat if you had hyperthyroidism. There's a whole nother set of foods for hypothyroidism, but pretty much this is what you will be eating if you had these issues as well. And also these foods have some antioxidant properties in there as well, which can help eliminate some of the free radicals and things that are in your body. And boom, that was my dang on hyperthyroidism report right there. I hope you all enjoyed it. I hope you all got some information from it. If you're having some of these issues, or you know somebody that's having some of these issues, please go seek some medical help. And you know, don't take my word for it. Do your own research for it. And that's it for me. This is Mike Cardi of Mike Card TV, and I'm out. Love you all. Love you all. Bye.